Hi everyone, Kasit Piromya once again this week. I would like to talk a bit more on Thai politics from the angle of one political dynasty of Thailand, namely the Chinawatra family, you know, the family of the former Prime Minister of Thailand, Mr. Thaksin Chinawat, who was at one time the Prime Minister of Thailand. And I think we could say that in the contemporary Thai politics, since the end of the absolute monarchy in 1932, Mr. Thaksin Chinawat could be considered to be the most successful, the most powerful, and the most influential Thai politics that Thailand ever had. And although successful, but he was charged with many corruption cases, the abuse of power. And now he is fugitive from the hands of justice of the judicial system of Thailand. He still has many outstanding court cases, and he has been sentenced to a 2-year imprisonment, and then he ran away. So he is a criminal fugitive, but from his point of view, he is a political exile personality. But it's not only him, but his younger sister also, who was subsequently the Thai Prime Minister and was ousted from power by the coup d'etat about 8 years ago in the year 2014. So both brother and sisters are fugitives of in political exile. But although physically Mr. Thaksin Chinawat is out of the country, having a sort of a semi-permanent residence in Dubai, in the United Emirates, okay, for so many years now. But his grip and his hold on power of the Pheu Thai Party is still very strong. He is still the most powerful and the most influential of the Pheu Thai Party. And why is it so? I think there are two explanations. One, he has a lot of money to look after the party and its member. It's no secret. Second, his populist policy measures are still in very much in the heart and mind of the people. People liked it because he was the first Thai politician to be able to communicate and at the same time to come out with populist policy measures that answered the needs of the people, especially the farming sector. And that under his project of commodity price guaranteed. And the other one is the a sort of a universal health care, 30 baht or a dollar fee per medical visit to the hospital, 30 baht for anyone, and so on. So the concern for the agricultural or the farming center, second, the concern for the health program, and third was, I think, the funding for social and rural development, you know, the village fund and so on. All of these measures have captured the heart and increased the popularity of Mr. Thaksin to this present day. And no other political parties so far have been able to come out with a set of policy measures that could challenge the populist policy measures, as I mentioned, of Mr. Thaksin. So the fault, or the, I think, is on the part of the other political parties that they have to provide alternatives to the Thai populace, okay? But that remains to be seen. But by not coming out with alternative policy measures, I think the popularity of Mr. Thaksin Chinawat continues. But it's not only his popularity and his grip on power. I think he also has been able to place his relatives in the position of the prime ministers of Thailand. Okay, after he was living for Thailand for exile, he was able to have one of his brother-in-law to become the Thai prime minister. Then it was followed by his younger sister. So three members, himself, the sister, and the brother-in-law, have become Thai prime minister in the last decade and a half. And they could have continued to be in power with relatives as prime minister if there were not to be the coup d'etat 6-7 years ago. But 2 weeks ago, it has become a sort of very big news in Thai political circle, in that Mr. Thaksin was able, or more or less, decided and ordered his daughter to become the chairperson of the innovative and participatory politics advisory committee of the Pheu Thai Party. What does it mean? It means that he is putting one of his relatives, namely his youngest daughter, into the political arena with sort of the power over the Pheu Thai Party. And second, he is placing his youngest daughter, who is about 35 years old, to be the one of the candidates for the prime ministership of Thailand in the upcoming election. So he is keeping family's member in the, what you call, top echelon of the Pheu Thai Party, and very much to be involving in the political life of Thailand. And that, I think, in a sense, confirms that his family is definitely a political dynasty that will become, continue to be part and parcel of Thai political life. Now, is it wise for him to place his youngest daughter on the public mantle or putting her in the political arena? I think all could not be that rosy, because it was alleged that 20 years ago, when his youngest daughter was about to get into the university, which in the Thai system, you have to pass the entrance examination. But it was alleged that Mr. Thaksin and his daughter were able to obtain the examination question beforehand. So she passed the entrance examination to the Faculty of Political Science at Chulalongkorn University, because she was able to write the answers or to know the question in advance. So that has become a sort of a dark spot for her, I think, reputation and the family reputation. So the fact that Mr. Thaksin is now, or has now, put his daughter on the mantle to be the next prime minister of Thailand, this entrance examination, I thought we could say cheating, would be a drawback. That's the something that of concern. And second is that, looking at more from the spiritual point of view, is it right for a father to put a daughter into the political arena, knowing well that certain issue would crop up that would be negative for the family and the daughter's reputation? Is it justified to put a daughter that is not well-versed in politics and so on to face the criticism and the challenges from the other political parties and so on? Okay, because he had put his youngest sister into the premiership, and she became the laughing stock of the Thai society because she was not well versed in politics. She was not articulate. She did not have the political sense, and she had to carry out policy measures that put her in jail. So she's also a fugitive running away from the court of justice of Thailand. And now Mr. Thaksin would like to put his youngest daughter onto the same mantle, and then he will be the conductor, you know, pushing the programs and so on to her. And the possibility of, I think, corruption practice under all of these populist policy measures, you know, that could not, I think, be discounted, but it's a possibility. But the other thing is that by when his daughter accepted the position of the chairperson of the advisory committee for strategy and innovation of the Pheu Thai Party, she gave a speech of acceptance publicly. And one of the things that she mentioned was that if she won the election to become the leader of the country and so on, she will try in every way to bring her father back from Dubai into Thailand scot-free, no court cases, no imprisonment and so on. I don't know whether that pronouncement publicly from the very first day of her stepping into politics was a wise thing. Because by then she is ignoring the judicial system of Thailand, and she is by implication and by default creating a stronger opposition to the return of her father by the sort of illegal means, you know. So that's going to be a problem for her and for the family, but it would be a problem more for her because she would be venturing into, I think, confrontational politics, and she will be, I think, confronting and challenging the judicial processes of Thailand. It doesn't bode well, you know, for her entry into politics. And in that sense, what one could also say that Mr. Thaksin Shinawat is hurting his daughter unintentionally, unconsciously or consciously, but you cannot put your daughter into a political arena with an instruction that you have, that the daughter has to do things that would be illegal, that would go against the moral precept of the society, or just to challenge the decency of Thai politics. So I leave this to you for you to understand a bit what's going on and to be able to follow better the coming developments of Thai politics. สวัสดีครับ. Thank you.